What's up? It's Allie Hardesty, and today's video is going to be yet again another catfish story time. If you guys have been on my channel for a while, you may have seen the one that I shared over a year ago, where basically there was this Facebook account that was following my every move for 5 years. They had tapped my phone, they had pictures I never posted, it was super creepy. They had one of my ex-boyfriend's cousin. It was this whole thing. I found out about it like 6 years later, and then I was contacted by MTV Catfish. I was going to be on the show, and then the profiles were deleted. I get questions about that all the time to this day. I still don't know who did that, and if you guys want to hear about that, check out the videos below because I will link them. That's way too much to get into in this video, but this is a whole nother experience. This was not the same person to my knowledge. I don't know. I'm gonna explain because I ended up finding out who actually did this, but this was a much more, I shouldn't say extreme situation. It was just very different. It wasn't even necessarily a profile. Someone was texting somebody I went to high school with pretending to be me, and it gets a lot worse from there. So without further ado, I'm just gonna get into the video. This occurred about, I would say, 3 or 4 days ago. I get a DM, a direct message on Instagram from my friend Lauren that I went to high school with. She was a grade above me, and we didn't know each other super well, but we had hung out one time, and we had followed each other on social media ever since. We'd always been pretty cool. She DM'd me saying that she really needed to talk to me. And so I responded like, yeah, what's up? And then I went on my Snapchat, and I saw another DM from her, and she was like, hey, did you get my inspo pic? I haven't talked to this girl in a couple years, mind you, like maybe even 4 years. It's been a while. Like, I moved away. We didn't go to the same school anymore. She lives in San Francisco. So like, we just kind of lost contact. So it was really, really random for me. And I was like, no, what are you talking about? And so immediately she responds on Snapchat, and she was like, dude, I need to talk to you. Can I call you right now, please? Somebody's been impersonating you, texting me. Can I call you right now? Can I explain what happened? And I'm like, yeah, sure. Like, what's up? Here's my number. Like, call me. So she calls me, and I didn't think it was gonna be that big of a deal. I thought it was gonna be something like, I don't even know. I really don't even know what I expected, but not what she tells me next, which is like in freaking insane. So basically, this number had been texting her, and I have all the receipts, I have all the screenshots. She looks up the area code. It's like a Bay Area number, which is where I grew up, that's where I'm from. So like, it looked pretty legit already. And they're like, hey, is this Lauren? It's Allie, get back to me when you can. And she's like, hi Allie, where do I know you from? Because she didn't know if it was me or a different Allie. Allie's a pretty common name. Like I said, we hadn't talked in like 4+ years. They're like, Hardesty, I used to be Gabe's ex. I'm almost positive you remember me. No? So they already know who I've dated in the past. They're already trying to back up that they're me, kind of trying to prove it. And she's like, yes, of course, how are you? Thinking nothing of it. Just like I would if I got a text from somebody and they were like explaining who they were. They're like, good, how about you? Listen, I know that you've been working so hard, working out, etc., and you look awesome. I'm still running a channel on YouTube, but also love doing photo shoots, etc. I think it would be awesome to do one of you. Body positivity is what I strive for. First off, I'm not a photographer. I have photographer friends who sometimes take pictures of me on Instagram. That's about it. I'm not a model. I don't know how to work a camera besides to literally set it on the tripod on the ring light and just press record. I am not talented in that department whatsoever, so already this is just not even accurate at all. But of course, she doesn't know that, and so she's like, yes, the girls I nanny for are super into YouTube, and we watch your videos. They think it's so cool that I used to go to school with you. That sounds awesome. Do you have any inspo or an idea of what you'd want it to look like? And bear with me, you guys. I'm just gonna kind of summarize the text for you, but it gets really, really freaking creepy. This person's like, haha, that's awesome. Are you pretty open as far as photo shoots go? Kind of like the pictures that I do of myself. I've honestly noticed doing body positivity in a sexual way not only boosts up people's confidence and makes you look good also, LOL. And she's like, yeah, your pictures look awesome. Are you wanting it to be kind of like your recent pictures? I did a photo shoot with a waterfall recently, and they're like, yeah, we can do that. I think you look awesome in a format like that, super sexy. Why would I say this to someone? This doesn't make any sense. But of course, like, she's gonna think that because we knew each other, and it still does kind of sound like me in the sense of like YouTube, who I used to date, all that kind of stuff. And so she's getting a little sketched out. You can tell by the messages. And then the person, me, is like, have you found any outfits? And then Lauren was like, not that I would wear exactly, but I kind of like the idea. And she sent a picture of Ashley Graham, who's a model, in a bikini on the beach or whatever, like in the water, just kind of like an inspo post, you know, something that you'd want to sort of recreate. And so I'm like, yeah, that would be awesome. Would you be down to do some booty shoots like that? LOL. Booty shoots. I suggest that she take some booty shots of herself and send them to me, and then I would edit them for her. Lauren's like, okay, like, do you just mean of my butt or like in the mirror? I don't wanna embarrass myself. Like, do you have an example of like what kind of picture you want me to send you? And so I'm like, text them to me whenever. The pictures don't have to be perfect. Maybe like slight face down, ass up, crotch shots, anything. Face down, ass up, crotch shots. She is like, I don't have pictures like that. I have some progress pics I could send you if you really want to see those, because she's been really into fitness and working out and like improvement pics. Like I post those sometimes, you know? And he was like, yeah, that's great. Make sure you get your ass in there and all this stuff. She ends up sending a body positive like progress pic, nothing inappropriate, something that she would just post to Instagram if she wanted to like show her progress, but she's not wearing much clothes in it because that's what I was asking, right? To like be half naked or whatever. So she sends over one of those. I am like, you're basically there. It'll be slightly difficult not having your butt in the picture fully. That's why I said more of a face down, ass up, ass facing mirror type thing. Then I am asking her to send pictures of her boobs. Basically more nude photos. Like, no, like take your clothes off more. I need to see everything for the full effect and all this stuff. So then Lauren tries to call this person because she doesn't believe it's me anymore and she wants to know what's going on. They don't answer, and then they text her saying that I can't get calls in Reading. I just don't have service up here. It's a long story, which doesn't make any sense because I'm literally a YouTuber. Like, don't you think I'd have pretty good Wi-Fi? I do. So then, this is when she Snapchatted me, when she was like, did you get my info pics? And she texts the number saying, did you get my Snap? And they're like, what did you send? And she's like, it's on Snap. And they're like, I don't receive messages because like my tablet's messed up because I have too many people messaging me. And she's like, but you just posted on there. Then I'm like, oh, I can post stuff, but I can't receive messages. She's like, okay, if this is really you, where do we run into each other years ago when I was dating AJ, her ex, and you were dating Gabe? They say, as far as I remember, I used to see you at the car meets at night when Gabe used to have his GMC Sierra and I believe AJ had a Toyota, right? Some truck with a shell on it. They literally knew what both her ex-boyfriend and my ex-boyfriend drove, like their cars from 4+ years ago, and where we met. And I didn't even remember that this is where we met. We met at a truck meet that used to happen in Brentwood all the time. My boyfriend used to be really into those back in the day, so I'd go with him. I just remember us going to Jack in the Box afterwards. I don't even remember us at the car meet. So when she was telling me that this person said that, I was like, how do they remember that and I don't? So this is when I got super creeped out. This is when she got in contact with me and she texts the person saying, LOL, I know this isn't Allie, and they don't respond. She and I are on the phone. We've read all the messages together and we're on the same page. Like, obviously it's not me. We're both shook. This person has to know us both like decently enough to be able to say all the things that they did, like where I live, who I used to date, who she used to date, what both of their trucks look like, where we met, where we hung out, how long ago it was, like all that stuff. And obviously you can find out a lot of this information through my YouTube and stuff like that. I'm not a super private person, but the fact that this person knew where she and I met when like nobody else was there is just weird. And so our first thought obviously is like, okay, it's either your ex-boyfriend AJ or Gabe, my ex-boyfriend. But me and Gabe are friends, and her and AJ are friends. Like, we're on really good terms with both of them, and that just wouldn't even be a thing. But that was the only thing we could think of. We were trying to figure out who this could possibly be, and she's just like, okay, it's gotta be my ex. Like, this is the only explanation I have. So she calls up her ex, and she's like, I'm not trying to accuse you. I'm just really, really confused because they knew all this information that basically only you would know about. So maybe you could help me out and help me figure out who this would be, because I'm really upset. They have these pictures of me now that maybe she wouldn't have felt comfortable posting or just sending to anyone, but she thought it was me, so she sent it to me. Her ex, AJ, is like, I'm pretty sure it's Tanner. We're gonna call him Tanner, who was AJ's ex-best friend or whatever, like back in the day. And so the whole time that Lauren was dating AJ, he was around. So he could easily have known a lot of this just from that. He wasn't there that night, to my knowledge, but I mean, maybe AJ and him talked about it later, or he knew from Lauren or something that that was how she and I met. And apparently he watches my videos too, so he'll probably see this. Shout out to Tanner. AJ's like, it was probably Tanner, because also apparently when her and AJ broke up, this is so insane to me. Like, I can't believe people actually go out of their way to do things like this. He was hitting her up, telling her that he would pay to have sex with her, asking her for pictures, all this stuff. While he's in a relationship, he still has a girlfriend right now. Like, I don't understand people like this. I really don't get it. She was like, AJ, that makes a lot of sense. Like, it totally could be Tanner. Why? I don't know, but it makes sense because he's done weird things like this before, but just off of his real number. You know what I mean? So maybe he thought, if she won't send me nudes, maybe she'll send nudes to Allie Hardesty, her friend from like 4 years ago, you know? So she goes ahead and she calls Tanner. Tanner picks up the phone. He's with his girlfriend. And he's like, no, I don't know what you're talking about. And Lauren doesn't come at him sideways. She is just basically like, hey, do you remember Allie Hardesty from high school? And he was like, I don't know, like maybe a little bit, like just playing dumb. And she's like, yeah, well, she has a YouTube channel, all this stuff, just kind of explaining it. And I don't even know what grade this guy was in. I don't really remember him at all. I just know what like she's told me at this point. And she's explaining the situation and she knows it's him at this point because like who else would it be? And she tells him that she's really nervous and she wants to get the police involved, even though she had no intentions of doing that. She just basically told him that that so he'd admit it. And so he's like, okay, hold on. And he walks outside, so he's not near his girlfriend, and he starts freaking out. He's like, Lauren, I'm shaking. I'm so sorry it was me. It was just a joke. I'm so sorry. I'll do anything to make it up to you. Who does this? Who does this? So that means that he was following my Instagram, my YouTube, anything he could to get all the information that he did about me in order to message her. And then just, I guess, really caring about her, even though he has a girlfriend, and just trying to do whatever he can to finesse. And I was super nervous this whole time before we found out it was him, because I was like, what if there's some creep out there messaging a bunch of different people I went to high school with, pretending to be me, asking for nudes? Because apparently it was believable enough for her to fall for it, and I don't want anyone to think I would ever do that. A one-time specific occurrence because he just wanted her nude specifically, because he's like obsessed with her, I don't know. But like, isn't that a scary thought to think that somebody could be impersonating you, texting people? Face down, ass up, right? That's something I would totally say. It just literally blows my mind. And so now he's trying to bribe her into silence. Like, I'll buy you these pair of sunglasses. I'll give you $200. Like, I don't even know what he's saying. She told me a whole bunch of stuff. And the best part is when she found out it was him, like when he admitted it, he was like, we're still cool, right? I don't want to ruin our friendship. And she was like, what friendship? I don't talk to you. This is literally why you had to use a fake number to pretend to be somebody else to talk to me. And I still don't understand if this guy bought another phone to do this or if it was a text-free app, because when she called it, it didn't say it was a text-free app. It just rang and then there was like a regular voicemail or something. So if you're already going to go to the extent to pretend to be another person that you don't even know and like stalk both of them in order to make the story straight, I'm pretty sure you'd probably buy another phone. So it would not surprise me. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, be sure to give me a big thumbs up. Leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new here, and also turn on my notifications by hitting that bell button right next to the subscription box. I have a lot of other really crazy little mini stories involving Instagram, like weird DMs I get. Also, I could just do a video reading weird comments, to be honest, but there have been some other little catfish experiences through Instagram that I kind of want to put in a video. If you guys want me to do sort of like an Instagram story time series, let me know, because that would be a lot of fun. Comment below letting me know if you guys would like to see that. Follow my social medias. I will have them all on the screen right here. Also, I do have a Patreon if you guys want private Snapchat, exclusive photo shoots, early videos. You can talk to me, message me on there. It's a lot of fun. I will have that linked at the top of the description box also. And I will see you guys in the next video. Later, alligators. Bye.